there and pose a question: what about me?
What about me?
What about me? It is critical to not that if you as an individual ask that question.
Yes.
What about me?
What about me?
Because we are intrigued, amen, with the think about others, amen, and making sure that all is well. Amen. We can even tell that within the service, that when the Spirit of God began to move, amen, how people began to get concerned about other people. Amen. There was nothing wrong with that, amen, because we know that sometimes things happen. Amen. But I just want you to be selfish for a moment and say, what about me? Amen, amen, amen. Because you need to understand that it's a serious relationship that you must develop with God for yourself. It's not about my sister, not about my brother, amen, but it's me, oh Lord, that's standing in the meat of something. And I'm going to tell you tonight that as we research scripture, amen, that the atmosphere, as Pastor said, is conducive for a breakthrough. Amen, amen. Let me tell you, let's go to scripture for a minute. Matthew 18, amen. Matthew 18 and 20. Amen. Matthew 18 and 20. 18 and 20, it reads like this. It says that, for where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. So. If you said the atmosphere was conducive for a breakthrough, the atmosphere was conducive for a change, it had to be because there was at least two or three people in the place touching and agreeing on the same thing in his name. Amen. Not in nobody else's name. Not in the name of the church. Amen. Not in the name of the neighbors or people on the job. It was in the name of Jesus Christ. So because we touched and agreed, gathering in one place in his name, he got to be in the midst. Let me claim that when Jesus is in the midst, things got to happen. And they will. When he is in the midst. Why is this revival in the name of Jesus so prevalent? I'm glad you asked. Acts chapter 4, amen. We're going to travel a little bit, amen, because I need to let you know something, that we are trying to reach everybody.
Other name under heaven given among men
whereby we must be saved. I need to let you know tonight, because there may be somebody in here that has tried to get it some other way. I can't assume that everybody here is a Christian, is a follower of Christ. I got to assume that somebody here is seeking to know Christ in a more excellent way, and they have tried other religions, or they're given He's coming. He's here. But there are some of you that believe not. For Jesus knew from the beginning who they were that believed not and who should betray him. He said, therefore I said unto you that no man can come unto me except you were given unto him of the Father. It says, what does verse number 66 say to me? From that time of him saying something out of his mouth based upon who he was and the word of God, they walked away and left him. I come to speak to somebody tonight because I come to revive who all. Somebody has walked away from the church based upon a stand that was given by your leader. It was meant to help you, not to harm you. What about me? Get yourself back in the house of God. Get yourself in order and find out what else do you have that would help my life. Beyond this moment, too many of us are stuck in moments. Too many of us are stuck in seasons. And it's not a man of God. You need to understand something tonight. I'm telling somebody, let it go and let God. We come to revive some folks on tonight. We come to revive all. We can't assume that you all are saved. We can't assume that you all are in this church and worshiping only as a Christian man or a Christian woman. We cannot assume that we have said something that may have not rolled you the wrong way. Because if we did say it, man, we would not be men and women of God. We got to say something that seems a little difficult, that seems a little challenging. Just to find out where you are. Are you one that's going to run when I put you to the test? We come to revive some folks on tonight. And the book of Mark, chapter number 9, it deals with some things. Amen. It deals with seven areas. But we've been talking about specifically in this particular chapter dealing with Mark, chapter 9, and verse number 17 through 24. You read the key verse on tonight. But let me help you on tonight. Because you said, the question on tonight that we posed, and the title of this message is, what about me? Well, we come on tonight to unlock the faith. Because if you get in the mindset that there is some other way to get to Jesus, to get to the Father, amen, it's not going to happen. He said, nobody gets up to the Father except he come by me. Amen, except he come by Jesus the Christ. Except he come by the Lord of Lords and the Kings of Kings. Except he accept the Lord as his own personal Savior. There is no way possible that he cannot be saved. So we got to tell you, we come to open it to release some things. We come to undo, to disclose, to lay open. We come to break in some fallow ground. We come to crack the hard surface that you are. We come to decipher what is going on. We come to liberate, in other words, to set some people free. We come to deliver some folks. We come to discharge some myths. Discharge some misunderstandings about Jesus. We come to alleviate, to eradicate, to stand out in the end of the night as God comes. We come on tonight to detach ourselves from the things that are causing us to go down into the pits of hell. We come to be disconnected. We come to let go. We come to separate. We come to unchain some things. It's time to unlock your faith. The Bible says in Mark 9 that it says that in 17 it says that the multitude had asked and said, Master, I brought unto thee my son, which hath a dumb spirit, and whosoever he teareth him, and he foameth and he gnasheth with his teeth and pined away. He says, I spake to thy disciples that they should cast him out. He says, but they could not. What I need to speak to you on tonight, as we talk about the subject of what about being an unlocking faith and unlocking your faith, I need you to do something in verse 17 and 18. I need you to recognize the seriousness of the matter and to request some help, because you need to understand your life.
circumstance be all it was. He said, I went to the disciples and they couldn't help me. But now I'm coming to you. I'm going to sit right here until something changes, until something happens on my behalf. I'm here to tell you tonight, you got to learn how to stay power. Stick and stay. Get stuck and stay. Take that hit on the road and stay in the race. Hang it down. I told you, look, I don't care what's saying. This man, he listened to what you had to say next. And he held right now. Because guess what? His chains had not come. What he had requested had not come to pass. I'm here to tell you, I don't give up on Jesus.
Come on.
The uncle and the nephew, the niece and the uncle.
to be helped in this very circumstance. He said, Lord, if you can do anything, what I need for you to do is have compassion. In other words, look on me in the state that I am. I'm messed up just as worse as my son is messed up. Because when he's going through, I'm going through it. I cannot function. I cannot move to the left or to the right because I constantly see turmoil and pain happening in his life over and over again. And I get so caught up in the turmoil and the pain that I felt I failed to recognize where the true source of my help and my power come from. I go for a moment, amen. I go and talk to the ministers. I go talk to the deacons. I go talk to the ones that teach Sunday school. And I go get an instruction and a revelation from them and see if they can help me. But there is only one shepherd of one house. The thing that happens unto us, we run to others because they'll tell us what we want to hear. They'll take us to their knowledge and their level of instruction. But there is only one shepherd that has been given charge over your soul, and that is responsible to go to God for you day and night, to labor before you in the midnight hour, and it is going to cry tears, that's going to walk, that's going to fast, that's going to turn down. God for you. There is only one shepherd. Stop going to people, amen, that don't have no best interest at heart. Sometimes they just want to see you get so far. So you can even be rich that they can pull you down. I don't want to come down. I want to go high. I want to go high. I want to go high. The father of the child, he said, cried out to the Lord with tears. He said, I believe. He said, help thou my unbelief. We come to a time for everybody. There is somebody at the point of a breakthrough, but you're still all between two opinions. You're still battling with some issues. You believe to the point that it doesn't require you some extra. You believe to the point that it doesn't require you to expose yourself. But this man got behind that type of issue. He was willing to expose himself and let himself be vulnerable before the Lord. And it finally came out after the conversation where he said, have compassion on us and help us. Amen. And the real deal finally came out. And then he began to cry. He began to cry loud. He began to express with tears what was really going on within his heart, within his mind. He didn't really have to call. Amen. Hello, somebody. He didn't really have to call. Amen. And go to the disciples and get them to do something. We got to learn how to get that hour. How enough faith was given us the same position. Heal thyself. Amen, to the situation to find out what was going on. people on tonight know that a lot of crowd of people, amen, ain't really there for your best interest. They just there to see what's going on. Can I tell you tonight to stop looking, amen, on somebody else's struggle and somebody else's problem? Because next time it could be you. Amen. You just a second away from a breakout. You just a second away from being messed up. You just a condition away from losing your mind. You just a problem away from falling in time. So stop running, trying to look. Get on your knees and pray. Get on your knees and pray. Get in your prayer closet and call upon the name of the Lord. And you might help somebody else. Jesus, he rebuked that foul spirit. He said, thou dumb and deaf spirit. He said, I charge thee, come out of him and enter into him no more. The spirit cried and rent him sore, came out of him, and he was as one dead. And so much that many said, he is dead. Verse 27, did you close your eyes? What did he say? So what are we saying on tonight? There comes a point in time where you can come to the Lord and the Lord can give you instruction. The Lord can give you insight on what he wants to do for your situation and for your problem. Amen. And there's a point where you still yet cannot get up out of that thing. Amen. Because
Am I worthy of such a touch? Am I worthy of such an honor? Am I worthy of such an anointing to fall my way? He says, I love you enough. Now go down and pray for you. And then I'll rise again to let you know that I have power over this life and the life to come. Concerned about you. You and you. And we got to learn how to be connected with God sometimes. What about you makes me so bad that you can't fix me? What about me that makes it so bad that I'm always the one getting in trouble and running out of the situation after situation? What about me that makes it the place that I'm the one that always in the arguments and the disagreements? What about me, Lord, that my children are always going through? What about me, Lord, that I'm the one that's always getting a short change on the job? And what about me, Lord, I have to keep apologizing, I have to be sorrowful over and over again. But Lord, what about me? Can you enter to me, Lord God, and can you touch me, Lord God? All of those things will never matter again. Because I know who's blessing me. I know who's healing me. I know who's delivering me. I know who's setting me free. And I know that after a while, he's going to make everything all right. What about you? What about you? What about you? I'm in a place. Lord, when I went revive after revival, and I put on the show, I put on the garment of praise, but I have not yet entered into praise. I put on the garment of worship, but I have not yet entered into worship. I put on the mask, and people can't even tell the difference between what's real and what's not. But Lord, I'm exposing myself on tonight. Lord, here I am. A wretch undone. I don't profess to know it all. I don't profess to have it all. I don't profess to have it all together. I'm still under construction. So Lord, break up the ground that's under me. That I have no support. Before you and come humbly submitted unto you, knowing that your hand extends all the way down to the lost parts of the earth. Scripture says if we go there, Lord, he will find us. We go to the depths of the sea, and he will find us. Him there. We said that tonight was time for you to be broken, that you might be built back up. It's time for you to submit under the will and the power of God. Submission comes as a willingness based upon the truth of the gospel. We have laid the word out to you tonight just as plain as we could. Submit yourself under, therefore, under the mighty hand. And he may exalt you in due season. Yes, yes, yes. You shall reap if you faint not. He's calling the backslider. He's calling the adulterer. He's calling the fornicator. He's calling you. 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 He sees you. He sees you behind the suit. He sees you behind the dress. He sees you behind the smile. He sees you behind your praise. He sees you behind your temporary worship. He sees all of that. He said, I got my eyes on you today. All you got to do is reach out. Grab what you need. In the place of surrender. Can we surrender? When we do that, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. When we do that, it's just like a child. When a child comes to you, they put their hands up, you reach down and you pick them up. Because you're depending upon them to hold you. You depend upon them to bring it close to you, to their heart. You depend upon them to do something mighty in your life. And if you need them tonight,
yes, Lord.
He don't have to go and skip across people to get to you. His arms are ready. There's a son or a daughter tonight. I don't care what you think your status.